believers to get dead dry bones on their feet. But I'm glad God can take impossible, hopeless situations and turn them around. You see, you don't worry about amen. You ain't gonna get none. Don't worry about praise the Lord. Don't worry about anybody supporting you. Just preach anyhow. Preach to the confused. Preach to the destroyed. Preach to the dead. Preach to the hopeless. Because the word of God is so powerful, it'll bring the dead back to life. The word of God is so powerful, it'll put marrow back in the bone. It'll put gristle back in the joints. It'll put sinews of flesh upon reconnected bones. Ezekiel, you just preach. And after you preach to the bones, then preach to the wind. You gotta preach to the seen and the unseen. You may be able to see the bones, but you cannot see the wind. You gotta have enough faith to speak to the invisible. After all, the God you pray to, you've never seen. The God you worship, you've never seen. The God you magnify, you've never seen. But we walk by faith and not by sight. I may not have seen him yet, but I will see him. Because he said every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess, and every eye shall see him. I'm going to see him for myself. But since this is a faith walk, I don't have to see him to believe him. You know, every now and then critics ask you, why do you serve a God you can't see? Well, you ought to ask them, why are you breathing air you can't see? Why are you inhaling oxygen you can't see? Every few seconds you're still inhaling and exhaling. Well, if you can keep on breathing, I can keep on lifting holy hands without wrath and doubting. God is real. Come on and touch somebody and tell them God is real. I know he's real. I can feel him deep down in my soul. James had a message for the diaspora. Those who are broken and scattered, just learn how to count. Count it all joy. In 78 years, Bishop James McNeil has learned how to count it all. Don't just count the mountaintops, count the valleys. Don't just count the victories, count the defeats. Don't just count your friends, but count your enemies. In fact, you might be eating better because of the enemies. God will prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. In fact, if you know how to count, every now and then, you ought to thank God for your enemies. I know it might seem a little unorthodox, but just lift your hand and say, Lord, I want to thank you for my enemies. Come on, tell them again, Lord, I want to thank you for my enemies. You see, God will fight for you when enemies fight against you. For David said, when the wicked, my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. The host should encamp against me. In this will I be confident. The Lord is on my side. I will not fear what man can do unto me. He knew how to count it joy. Whatever happens to you, count it joy. When you talked about, count it all joy. When you misunderstood, count it joy. When you hate, count it all joy. When you're hungry, count it all joy. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. In fact, that's how Jesus made it.